friend of 7 years, Christina. Yeah, we met my freshman year of high school, played field hockey, and we've been best friends ever since. Christina goes to PC, and she is the president of PCTV. So she's actually here today filming some footage for a segment on Loving Him Was Brown, the Taylor Swift Club. So, like, up first, we have a reputation makeup bag. Yes, a reputation makeup bag. To the right, we have a cat mug, a very on brand for Taylor. She loves cats.
How many singles were released from Taylor's first album?
How many specific locations in London does Taylor mention in London Boy, and can you name them all? Okay, hey, the answer was 9 locations.
Taylor dressed up as who when she performed Frozen with Idina Menzel in the 1989 tour?
This is another two-parter. How many cats does Taylor own and what are their names? What type of tree did Taylor's ex-boyfriend, Calvin Harris, plant in her backyard?
Question is in the lyrical category. So what song contains the lyrics, "Struggle through the night with someone new"?
In which American television sitcom did Taylor make a cameo playing a girl named Elaine? When Taylor was in fourth grade, what type of national contest did she win?
What is the name of the novel that Taylor wrote when she was 14?
Wait, the answer was A Girl Named Girl.
In my eyes, SSD said Starlight, Cowboy said Born to be a Star, Emily said The Christmas Sweater, This is my experience, Mame said Lost Girl, kind of close,
close, Mame, close.
And Team Nasrin said Ligma.
Hi, my name is Caroline. I'm the co-president and co-founder of Loving Him Is Brown, and my favorite Taylor Swift song is probably New Romantics from 1989.
My name is Michael Ye. I'm the other co-president and co-founder of Loving Him Is Brown. My favorite Taylor Swift song is New Year's Day.
Tell me about your club.
So our club is Loving Him Is Brown, the Taylor Swift Club. And we're asked very often, what do you guys even do? And the first thing I always say is, what don't we do? We do just about everything Taylor Swift related in the club. We talk about Taylor Swift news. We watch Taylor Swift performances and music videos. We analyze them. We analyze song lyrics. We debate what album is the best, what song is the best. We get people's personal stories about Taylor Swift. We have them bring in objects they love about Taylor Swift. We do anything related to Taylor Swift. And I think the inspiration of the club is, you know, we obviously are big fans of the singer-songwriter legend, but we want people to have a space where they can, you know, be themselves and be not worried about school and just like appreciate something and someone they love, and it's like a great space for people to bond and make friends, and that is probably one of the biggest parts of the club.
Yeah, we also, in addition to our weekly meetings, we also host larger events for, you know, the Brown community. So tonight we just had our Taylor Swift trivia night. We've also done Taylor-oki twice. And during the Red re-release, we had a lot of stuff going on. So we did a video, like a movie premiere for the All Too Well 10-minute music video, as well as a midnight listening party for Red Taylor's version, where we literally were up till like 2:30 a.m. listening to that album. But it was a great time.
It was
so fun, yeah. Like any other club here, we went through the application process, we wrote some essays, met with some other club leaders who have similar clubs to us, and then we met with the SAO representative, and we submitted an application, and then we found out a few weeks later that we were approved. You know, Brown like really wants to make sure that every single niche on campus, there's like a niche for everyone on campus, and we felt like this was an open niche. Like, nobody had ever done this before. So it was kind of a no-brainer to let Loving Him Is Brown happen.
Yeah, I agree with all of that. It was not too hard of a process because I think it was such an unmet need. One other thing we had to do is we had to get, I forget how long it had to be, but a list of prospective members. But we just kind of went all out and we're like, let's get a lot.
I think it was 10, but we were shooting for like 50.
Yeah, we were like, let's be convincing here. I think we ended up probably getting like over 100.
Yeah.
And yeah, so we just stood outside the dining hall and blasted some Taylor Swift music and asked people if they would sign up for our club. And that was like one of the first moments that I really saw just so many people so enthusiastic and wanting to make the club. Also, when talking to some of the other clubs, a few of them were like doubtful that this club would get approved. But it's definitely, I think, as Caroline said, on that space. So.
But you know who else was doubted early in her career? Was Taylor Swift. And look at us now. Look at us now.
That's
great question, Christina. Great question. Yeah, we know there's a bit of a rivalry, among the Providence universities for which college is the top Taylor Swift university. We believe it's us just because we have an organized program dedicated to Taylor Swift and all of her songs, whereas over at PC, you guys just kind of sing a song sometimes at a basketball game, which, might I add, that's not super fair because, Brown, we don't have a ton of student turnout at the basketball game, so it's not even like we can do that. We do go to class a lot, though, so, you know, we meet in this lecture hall to talk about Taylor Swift. I will say, though, at the end of the day, if you're appreciating Taylor Swift, we gotta condone it. You know, you can't go wrong. We still believe that we are the top Taylor Swift college in the greater Providence area.
And in the nation.
The world. We strongly believe that Lubbock comes down to Taylor Swift College. But again, PC, if you ever want to do a joint event to celebrate Taylor, we won't say no.
I think we both have a lot of dreams for next year and the future in general. I hope the club just continues to stay strong and continues to grow, both in, you know, quantity of members, people on the listserv, and people coming to meetings, but also just like in enthusiasm at our events and meetings. It's really great to see people getting into it. So I hope those things both continue to rise. I think it would also be great if we wanted to take a trip to Watch Hill and do a
respectful trip.
Yes, of course, of course. So I think that would be a great field trip.
I think we want Taylor to come to a meeting. Yeah. Like, hello.
That's the ultimate dream.
Yeah, and I think we can make it happen. This was actually our first year as a club, so I think that this is a great way for us to kind of figure out what works well and what doesn't work as well. And I think next year I'm really excited for us just kind of better idea of what makes the club so successful and like hone in all those elements. And I think that we're gonna have like a ton of great events. I think hopefully a re-release is coming out soon, so we can do like an even bigger listening party. Maybe get some funding for some more roller skating things. But I really
I mean the club, even just in our first year, I don't know about Caroline, but is bigger and has done more than I really expected or could have imagined it to. It's exceeded our wildest dreams, well said, already. So I don't even really know what next year holds, but I'm really excited. Another hope of ours is that a lot of our club members are underclassmen, and we hope that they kind of start stepping into leadership roles, and the legacy and continuation of the club is really important to us. So by the end of next year, we hope to leave it in good hands.
Wait, I have a request question. Can Michael and I tell the story of how we met?
Yeah.
Because I feel like that's important.
Okay, tell us how you met.
Should we both tell it, or should I tell it from my perspective and then you tell it from your perspective? But it's kind of the same story. Or maybe we both tell it and then you can do like editing, so like you fill in the gap.
You know, sometimes it's the question is why did you start the Taylor Swift Club? And we love Taylor, obviously. But a big thing is the Taylor community and making friends. And one of my first friends at Brown was Caroline. And Caroline is now one of my best friends at Brown. And one of the biggest, if not the first reason that we became friends or talked was Taylor Swift.
Okay, here's what happened. So we were at, Michael and I both transferred to Brown. We came in for our sophomore year. We both transferred from Catholic academic institutions, Georgetown, Notre Dame, and we both love Taylor Swift, but whatever. So anyway, we were at like a little gathering. It was an intimate group, maybe like 15 kids. And somebody started talking about what kind of music they like. And I was like thinking to myself, and Folklore had just come out like that past July, and it was like August.
Also, I mean, we're both new, like, there's like just these kids in a room who you like kind of know and you want to pretend you know people, but you're kind
of
nervous.
And you know, it's Brown, so they were getting very artsy on us. But I was like, you know what? I'm just gonna throw it out there. They were talking about what music they liked, and I was like, I'm just gonna throw it out there. I was like, has anybody listened to Folklore? And from across the room, Michael like shot up his hand and he was like, oh my god, I listened to Folklore.
I think I was maybe mid-conversation with someone else. I don't even know what it was about or who they were. Just completely dropped it. And I heard Folklore and I was just...
And then I was like, and he was like, yeah, I love Folklore. And then I was like, August? And then he was like
August!
This is my favorite song! And I was like, it's my favorite song too! So then obviously, automatically, we just started talking, like, about Taylor Swift and all that, and, like, you know, instant besties.
Folklore theories, hype songs from Folklore that are secretly hyped.
Yeah.
Anything else related to Folklore, and obviously just like Taylor Swift, to Taylor Swift. Yeah.
And then, fun fact, that night, somebody was opening a window, and I was sitting beneath the window, and the whole window fell out and hit me in the back of my head.
Like, crazy.
It was so crazy. It was literally like a whole window just crashed over my head and like crashed on top of me. And so then I like went back to my room because the window fell on my head. And that night, like, people were being nice and they were like texting me, like, oh, I hope you're okay, you know, let me know if you need anything. And when Michael sent me a text, like, oh, I hope you're doing well. And then I was like, oh, yeah, I am. And then I can't even remember what it was, but I threw in a Taylor Swift Taylor Swift one. And then Michael responded. And I remember I got the text, and it was, like, a weird text. Like, it was kind of formatted. And I was like, oh, this kid's kind of weird. Like, I don't know, like, maybe I should be friends with him. And then literally 3 minutes later, I was like, oh, my God, like, he put a Taylor Swift reference into the text, and that's why I was like kind of like weird, because it was like in Taylor's words. And I was like, because I didn't think he would pick up on the Taylor Swift reference that I sent him, but I actually didn't pick up on the Taylor Swift reference that he sent to me. So then I was like, oh my gosh, like, just best friends.
Yeah, and you know, you just never know. Like, there could be a Swift sitting right next to you.
That's why we get all kinds of people in the club, like, people talk about it in general, just like, always throw Taylor's name. Like, you never know, you can meet one of your best friends.
Okay.
Yeah. Successful.